2 days. That's the length of time Gerard Piqué spent in a coma when he was a child. And football is partly to blame. You didn't know? Hold on to your hats. The surprises have only just begun. Discover 10 crazy things about Piqué. Number 1. First of all, going back to this incredible coma story. At 17 months old, Gerard fell 13 feet from his maternal grandmother's balcony while playing football. This fall left him in a coma for 2 days. I'm sure that it set me straight. In any case, that's what my grandpa often says. His mother, a neurosurgeon, was tasked with following her son's neurological developments after his accident. Number 2. One day, Piqué was unfortunate enough to let his phone ring in the Manchester United locker room before a match, which caused Roy Keane to unleash hell. He shouted to everyone, "Whose telephone is this? Silence! Who does this f***ing telephone belong to?" Go on, Gerard. Admit it. In the end, I spoke up like a little boy. Very softly, I said, "I'm really sorry. It's mine." Roy lost his mind. He went crazy in front of everyone. It was incredible. I nearly shit myself. Since then, Piqué's phone is always on silent. Number 3. Staying with his mishaps in Manchester, one day Piqué had a satellite dish installed at his house so he could watch all the TV he wanted. So what? Do you think we care? No, but he had the satellite dish installed 4 times. 4 times! Yes, because each time the technician came, he stole the satellite dish he was meant to be installing. Very sneaky. Number 4. Part of the reason Rakuten became Barca's sponsor is because of Piqué and Shakira. Shakira and Piqué are very good friends with the founder of Rakuten, and they organized a dinner in San Francisco in 2015. We met and we talked about the future and Rakuten's interest in our club. Piqué helped us a lot. Gerard is a great guy. Number 5. He's also great at pranks. When Bojan was at Barca, Piqué filled his car with sugar. He also spent a lot of time entertaining himself by taking the battery out of Messi's phone. He even pretended to be Fabregas at a car dealership in order to get a quote on a car, which he had to return to a fan. Gerard is really a funny guy, huh? Number 6. Sometimes his foolishness is less funny. On his way out of a casino in 2015, Piqué lost it with a police officer who had given him a fine for obstructive parking. "You're giving me a fine because you'll make money, because you don't have enough money and you want a commission. Your father will pay this fine." When last we checked, the police officer's father hadn't paid for anything. Number 7. During a flight, the man with an IQ of 140 didn't use it to his advantage. He made the entire cabin crew hate him because he spoke rudely, refused to put on his seatbelt, and covered the ground with sunflower seeds. You could have at least shared them with your neighbors, Gerard. Number 8. When Piqué was young, Louis van Gaal, Barca's coach at the time, came to have dinner at his grandfather's house, an influential man in the club. Over the course of dinner, Piqué said that one day he would play for the first team. Except for at 13, 14 years old, Piqué was straight up rejected. "He pushed me. He threw me to the floor. He told me I wasn't strong enough to be a Barcelona player." Huh. We thought Van Gaal would have been more compassionate. Number 9. Piqué loves football, Colombian music, etc. However, less people know about his passion for mushrooms. Once a month, Piqué goes on a little mushroom gathering trip in the countryside. Make sure you don't take any magic mushrooms. Otherwise, is this real life? Number 10. Piqué is Catalan and pro-independence. His political engagement has earned him boos in Spanish stadiums everywhere. The political climate between Catalonia and Spain has become so tense that Piqué, who is mixed up in it all, chose to take his international retirement. He now plays for the Catalan team.